I met Jerry in 2014 after he had been reporting hoarseness, trouble swallowing, and a sore throat for about 6 months. And on office exam, he had a laryngeal cancer with a paralyzed vocal cord. It was bulky and filled a lot of the airway. He was aspirating, and he already had significant nodal disease. At that time, of course, we talked about options of surgical treatment and non-surgical treatment, but unfortunately his imaging showed he had distant metastatic disease involving the lungs, which takes curative treatment off the table.
I was in dire straits when I first got there. I mean, the doctors up here only gave me 4 months to live, and that's with some treatment to help me live a little longer with the feeding tube. When I got up there, they didn't even say anything about a feeding tube, and they wanted to put me on treatments, you know, right away.
So in 2014, the guideline recommended treatment for distant metastatic disease is systemic chemotherapy. And Jerry started off with the combination of the usual agents, platinum-based chemotherapy, 5-FU, and cetuximab. And the goal was never to cure disease, because we know chemotherapy does not cure head and neck cancer. It was to palliate symptoms. After 5 months of chemotherapy, he stopped treatment for 3 months because he had no evidence of disease on scans and he was feeling well. Unfortunately, in September of that year, 8 months after the initial presentation, he came to the office with dermal metastases. And that's again a sign of distant metastatic disease that is spreading throughout the body through the bloodstream. And unfortunately, because he had already gone through most of the chemotherapeutic agents, and this had progressed despite that, he was running out of options. Now, fortunately, at that time, we participated in a clinical trial called J1337, which was a new trial aimed at studying immunotherapy in terminally ill patients who had already had conventional chemotherapy for metastatic disease and had failed. And so Jerry was a perfect candidate for this trial, which looked at Pembro. Pembro is one of the monoclonal antibodies aimed at PD-1 receptor. So Jerry was all game and signed up for the trial, and his response has been nothing short of remarkable.
With the idea about a clinical trial would probably be better for me if it worked. And so she started me on the mystery drug. There were quite a few of us on it before. Some of them had some bad reactions, and I never had any reactions but good off of it. It was just all good. The bumps where it metastasized on my neck, they started shrinking. And when I was doing the clinical trial, it wasn't hard on me at all. I would leave here Monday night, catch a plane, take the treatment, and most Tuesday nights I'd fly home. So I'd only be going away one day, one full day.
The J1337 trial was one of the earliest trials looking at immunotherapy in head and neck cancer patients. I believe it included other cancer subtypes, but we really didn't know in 2014 if immunotherapy was going to be effective in head and neck cancer and which patients were going to respond and what the response rate would be and even what the side effect profile would be. So this trial utilized pembrolizumab, and it entailed infusions of pembrolizumab once every 3 weeks indefinitely until we saw a response. And Jerry had a total of, I want to say, 26 infusions, and his scan showed a remarkable response.
I feel good for an old man. I mean, honestly, I'm 71 now, and I feel I probably get around work better than some of the guys that are 50. And honestly, I feel honestly good in 99% of the time. I'm happiest man in the world still be alive, and everybody still calls me the miracle man here And because I was a, you know, dead man walking.
He has been off treatment for over a year and continues to have no evidence of disease on scans and live a very active, normal life.